Hi everyone, it's nice to see you back. This is Orlando at Wishcasting, and today I'm going to be covering two main topics. The first topic is some changes, huge changes that the UAE did for the expats living there or for the expats that will be relocating there. If you're going to find yourself in that position, just stick around and listen to the updates. They're really good. And the second thing that I wanted to talk about might concern you in case you're applying or wanting to apply for a Middle Eastern airline. If you are thinking of applying for a professional airline in the Middle East, stick around because this is a video for you. I'll try to give you like the pros and the cons and also my personal view on this, on these changes and why they happened and why did they happen now and they didn't happen since the very beginning when expats started moving to the UAE. I just want to ask you a question. Would you move out with a woman or with a guy without knowing them? Would you want to know them first before moving out? And what would you say if I told you that the UAE didn't allow anyone to move in with anyone of the opposite sex unless you were married? So in order for me to live with someone, I had to be married to them. But if I want to try to live with someone because you only get to know that person 100% once you start living with them, if I wanted to try to figure out how it is to live together, I would have to get married. How do you find that? What's your take on that? How do you feel when I tell you that? In Europe, in the US, in many other countries around the world, you don't have to be married to live with someone. And because of that, you can establish that the relationship is healthy and if it can continue to the next level, which is getting married. It's not the other way around where you first get married and then get the taste of how it is to live with that person and then say, oh damn, I really don't like this. I'm just gonna quit the relationship and that's it. But I'm not here to teach anyone how things are supposed to go, but I'm here to say that expats are expats. They're not local population. And in my opinion, you should have guidelines for everyone, but you should be also flexible. You should allow expats to use their principles, use their methods of getting to know each other and figuring out if they can be together as a couple before forcing them to getting married. The changes now, let's talk about the changes. The UAE integrated a new law where expats can live together, even of the opposite sex, absolutely no problem with that, and you do not need to have a marriage certificate. This is only applicable for expats. Now, this is a great change because you're being flexible and you're allowing other individuals that don't come from your same background, your same culture, they don't share your same religion, you're allowing them to continue what they had like back home in your country. So that's great. But the thing that kind of bugs me is that why didn't they do this earlier? For a really long time, the UAE had this alcohol license. If you had this license and you declared you were an expat and you weren't Muslim, then you had thumbs up on buying alcohol. Now, what's the difference between that and living out together? We're still expats. If you were selling alcohol to expats before based on religion, why are you now changing to allowing expats to live together before marriage, so without a marriage certificate, only now? Why are you doing this? Why couldn't you have done it before? Yeah, I understand that people take some time to adapt, to learn, and to see things from a further away perspective. But in my opinion, the way I see this, because this could have done a long time ago and you had it for the alcohol, but you didn't have it for couples living together of the opposite sex. So to me, it sounds like a little bit of a desperate attempt of retaining or also making your country more appetable to foreigners. We've seen a lot of people getting laid off. We've seen a lot of people leaving the UAE. It's not good for the worthiness of a country, and it's the trust is like foreigners are not trusting in the UAE that much anymore because a lot of them are being laid off and contracts are changing, they're earning less. It's everything is a little bit kind of harsh in the UAE now. So in my view, what they're doing is they're trying to retain or trying to show that it's a country worth living in by changing rules that were extremely rigid before and now are becoming more flexible. Like, what pushed the UAE to become more flexible and why right now and not 5 years ago or 4 years ago or 3 years ago? If they caught a couple of opposite sex in the same apartment, house, or what you want to call it, they would get arrested. And now just like that, the UAE are tolerant towards expats living together of the opposite sex. So for me, it sounds kind of like a little bit of a desperate attempt to keep people. I don't know, I might be wrong, but I want to see it from far away myself, and I gotta say that this change is for the good. So I'm not complaining. I'm just a little bit trying to figure out things. I wanna ask you ultimately what you think about it. Maybe comment down in the comment section and let me know what you think about it. I don't know if you've seen it all over the news, but Israel and the UAE tied together and they got down, they sat down. Practically now they're sort of allies. They have partnerships, they have mutual cooperations on several things. So it's kind of a good thing. So I kind of see that the UAE are broadening their view and they're being more flexible on several other fronts, which is a really great thing. Now finally, let's get to the second part of the video, and this will interest you if you are planning or already planned or already applied to join a Middle Eastern airline, such as Qatar Airways, Etihad Airways, Emirates Airlines. This information was specifically given to me by a candidate that applied for Etihad. Really good news, wait for it. We don't know if it's applicable for Emirates and for Qatar Airways and other airlines around, but it should be because they share the same clients. They've been struggling through the same exact hiccups, let's say, ups and downs in this aviation journey through the pandemic. This candidate told me that he was called recently from the HR coordinator, the HR recruiter and coordinator, if he was still interested in the job at Etihad as a flight attendant. And so he said, yes, of course. And she said, okay, so we will be calling you soon. And he said, would you have an estimate on that? She's not 100% sure that things are still developing. They're still planning and finding out how and when.
You might be tempted to say this can't be possible. They're still laying off cabin crew. How can they possibly be considering new recruitments? That's true. Etihad, Emirates, and other airlines are still cutting their workforce. 2 days ago, a memo was released by Etihad stating that there will be new job cuts. Some internal source said that about 1,000 jobs are at stake now. But if you look at the big picture, it's not a question of passenger demand only. It's also a question of contracts. Older contracts are expensive, with better benefits and salaries. If companies renew their workforce and replenish it with new contracts with less to be expected benefits, the company is future-proofing its existence. The equity of a company is based on its liabilities. The fewer liabilities, the higher chance of survival. I'll be doing a video about this soon. Subscribe to get notified.
But this is really good news because this proves the point that Etihad is getting back on track. So Middle Eastern Airlines are getting back on track. And if you've seen, I can share it. I'll share the screen now. But if you see the Sheikh, the owner of Emirates, he shared the results. I'm not sure if it's the semester results. He expressed his sort of frustration for the fact that there was a huge loss in the profit and the revenue that the airline made. They lost about $3.8 billion. But he also mentioned that there is hope because there's a vaccine that has been identified as very successful. It's through the third phase, it passed the third phase, and now it's entering in the fourth phase of trials, which I'm not exactly sure what that means. Probably it's being used on humans maybe now. I don't know. I would have to dig in more information and find out more. But what I know is that I think the fourth is the final phase, and that means that once these tests are over, the vaccine will be available for people around the world. And that means that within the next year, early year of 2021, the vaccine will be available. So I don't know which countries will get it first, but give or take, that's going to be the beginning of the end of this pandemic, and finally this exponential growth coming back to regular patterns in the aviation industry, both hirings and also routes and flights and operations. I'll be sharing a couple of links down in the description. Feel free to go there and check that information out. I did this video quite quickly because this news is very fresh, very new. Today's Thursday, and I want to make this video available for Sunday so that everybody is up to speed with everything and all the recent changes and information. But feel free to check those links. They'll contain a lot of information that I probably didn't cover. If you found this video interesting or helpful, don't forget to hit the like button. Don't think you're not helping us. Every like helps us all the time. And if you're really getting a lot of value, don't forget to hit the subscribe button. I'm looking forward to seeing you next Sunday for our next video. We do videos every Sunday at 5 p.m. Plus 1 GMT now. It's Prague time. You can look up Prague time. And it was a pleasure to have you here. I'll see you next. Bye. This is the moment where I become a little bit more personal and I share with you a little bit of my story.
It's been happening for the last 2 months. I applied for 2 job interviews. I got to the final phases, and it was me, let's say, with another guy. And unfortunately, he got the job. They had to go back to the initial stages and see who performed best at all the stages. And even though we both reached the final interview, they had to go back and check how we performed in the other phases. And lately I've been quite down. I've been quite, not depressed, because I think that depressed is a very tough, hard word, harsh word, something that you really have to, like, you can only talk about it and you can only say that you're depressed if you really know what depressed means. And I can't just say that I've been depressed, because it's not true. But I have been down because of this. For the last 2 months, it's been a struggle. And I just applied for another corporation and I went through phases of those interviews. And I gotta say, I don't feel like it's been a very good interview. I don't know the result yet, but I kind of feel it, that it's not good. So because of that, I just wanted to make myself feel better by buying something. And I bought these microphones. These microphones are wireless, something that I didn't really need so much because I already have other wireless microphones, but the size factor is super compact. So look, I'll go away. See? I'm quite far. I'm out of focus, I know, but it still works. It's super cool. Like, I could go down here, but I don't want to die. It's very steep, but it works. And this made me happy. Now, there's another thing that can make me happy, and you guys can help me in making me happy. Now, there's an area on the screen, whether you're on the phone or on the computer or a tablet or, I don't know, whatever other device you're using. It's sort of a hand shape. It's like a thumbs up, they call it, or a like button. I don't know if you're aware of that. I just want to show you a trick, a magic trick. Now, if you hover your thumb over the like button, or with a mouse cursor, you go over that like button, and at the count of three, you wait for the count of three, yeah? And at the count of three, you click, something's gonna happen, okay? So go with your cursor over the like button, go with your finger over the like button, and at the end of my count of three, click, okay? So 3, 2, 1, click. See what you did? You made me happy. Okay, so a lot of you maybe made the mistake and clicked on the thumbs down, you know, so like a dislike. So let's just fix that, you know. Don't click that. Go with your cursor above the like button. And at my 3, 2, 1, at the end of my countdown, click, okay? 3, 2, 1, click! I'm an idiot. All right, so if you manage to do that, you should have a resulting thumbs up or like button in blue. If you have a white button, that means you clicked it twice or you never clicked it. And if you have a thumbs down, then, guys, why? Why? You are so mean. Thank you for participating at this game and for supporting me and making me smile. And I shall see you on our next video. Orlando signing out. Peace.